Hi. How are you? Nice to meet you. How are you? Nice to meet you. Thank you for having me.
My name is Sue. This is my husband, John. We're from Hapag, New York.
Would you like water or anything?
I'm good, thank you.
We're having Theresa at our home in the hopes that our son, Shane, comes through. Since Shane passed away, we both have a lot of anger inside. And the relationship just, it hasn't been there.
My wish for you over this next hour is that you receive the message that will help you to make tomorrow a little bit easier.
Okay.
So, who's the young male that's departed?
Is that
your son?
Mm-hmm.
Did your son have some type of disabilities and or ailments?
Yes. Down syndrome. My son Shane was born with Down syndrome and he was sick most of his life. So we were together every day. He was everything to me.
Were you just watching videos of him?
Yes.
Because he goes, come watch me on TV. Uh-huh. I go, you were on TV? He goes, yeah, come watch the videos.
This morning, right before you came.
Just watching before you guys came.
We were watching it.
So know when you were watching the video, know that your son's soul was with you at the exact moment.
Oh my God. That is unbelievable.
Say hi, Shane.
Okay.
No, say hi.
Hi.
When my son was born and I found out he was special needs, I didn't care. I said to my wife, I said, you know what, we're complete now. We have a son, we have a daughter, we're a complete family.
He wants me to tell you, Dad, that you are his best friend.
Shane was the sweetest kid I've ever known in my life. He was my son. He was my son.
Do you try to go back to that day?
Every day.
Every day.
Because he said that he would always test you.
Mm-hmm. By the doors.
But I feel like he ran mm-hmm. and was gonna run like right back. Because I felt like then I fell.
He fell in the pool. And John was home with him when this happened.
My wife and my daughter went to a birthday party, so Shane and I stayed here. I met him on the phone a minute or two. And I got off the phone and I came into the room and Shane was gone. I got up on the deck and there he was in the pool. I mean, I did CPR on him and he started throwing a border, so I thought maybe there was a chance. But, you know, once we were in the ambulance, I started seeing that it's just going really bad.
Unfortunately, a lot of times when parents lose a child, they don't stay together.
I'm working on that. I just feel robbed. I've been robbed of all the joy he brought me. There are times I act out with him and I feel terrible because I have such anger inside of me. Since Shane passed away, you know, on my husband's watch, the anger that I have felt towards John, it increases at times.
Shane, dance!
He was such a huge part of my life. And the void of not having him here makes me angry.
I don't know if you know about the soul and how it chooses its destiny, because he wants me to tell you, Dad, your soul's journey was to carry this burden for her, to save you from that guilt. He carries that for you because he doesn't want you to feel an ounce of what this man carries every day of his life. I mean, he showed me you taking him out of the pool and the way that you helped him.
I do feel better that I was chosen to carry this, and it's not my daughter or my wife. Because of my carelessness, it cost him his life. And that's something that'll never go away from me for the rest of my life. You see, time heals all wounds, but not this one. It's just too big.
He says, Theresa, my mother knows deep in her soul that it's not my dad's fault. Please take care of each other.
Try.
He says, Theresa, he says, my family has lost so much. I don't want them to lose each other.
Oh my God. I've been carrying lots of anger inside. And to hear Shane say that he wants us to stay together, it does give me hope.
I hope.
Thank you, Theresa.
It has helped you
it
in
has.
Some way.
You've given us a
well,
gift.
I, you. Your son did.
Thank
your
you.
Your son gave you what you
Thank
needed.
You so much.
You're very welcome.
After this reading today, we're definitely going to work on this family, because that's what Shane wants.
Thought we were done with this stuff.
We haven't looked at chandeliers yet. My daughter Victoria is coming home from school today, and before things get really crazy, Larry and I have to run some errands. And one of those things is shopping for a chandelier. This is what I want. That's exactly what I envisioned. This is it.
Okay, we're done. We'll take two of these.
I don't know why we're going chandelier shopping today. We don't even have walls up.
Oh, wait, they even got better stuff. Look at this.
I think we're gonna be here for a while.
I don't know what to do. I'm so confused.
I could care less about this chandelier. Just pick one and let's get out of here.
Hi, welcome to Elements.
Hi, how are you? Nice to meet you. I'm Theresa.
Dina.
Dina, pleasure. My name's Larry.
Okay, what are we looking for?
I love this, but then like I look over there and I'm like, oh my God, I love that.
Believe it or not, I'm terrible at making decisions.
What are you looking for? Okay, we'll see what we can do. This is the crystal area. Now, a lot of things that you see here can come in different sizes, different colors.
Oh, okay.
What have you.
Can I ask you something? Why do I feel like you lost everything? I'm a medium, which means that I'm able to connect with people that have crossed over.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. I don't believe in mediums. I just always thought it was a whole bunch of guesswork and nonsense.
Now, whose husband departed?
Mine.
So just know he's stepping forward. Do you still have on your dresser at home his cologne? So do you ever smell his?
Oh my God. That's exactly what I have there.
Perfect.
Wow. That is the only thing on the dresser that's his.
Did he always brag about how beautiful
he was? He was very bad. He did that all the time. It was so embarrassing.
Well, he's still doing it.
If I was in a bathing suit, he snapped a picture and then showed it to the whole world like he was married to Miss America.
Every time he ends a sentence, or he's handing you roses.
Every time I went away on a business trip, I got roses.
Did he call you Dee?
That's exactly what he called me.
He goes, Dee, you are more beautiful than ever. He says, Dee, I want you to know that I haven't left you and know that my soul will be with you.
Well, he made my day. Today, Theresa made me the happiest person in the whole world. She told me what I really yearned to hear.
You're wonderful.
Yesterday, I would have told you I absolutely don't believe in mediums, but today I changed my mind. Oh, my God, you made my whole day.
Oh, well, you're going to make my day by helping me pick out this chandelier, right?